Hey guys, and welcome back to my channel. And today's video is going to be another hashtag worth the hype series. So this is one which I feel a lot of you were really really interested in, and I remember when I did a poll and I asked you guys to choose on Instagram if you wanted me to review and do like a hashtag worth the hype video for the Kiehl's Midnight Recovery Concentrate or the Estee Lauder ANR. And I feel like both of them had very very close, I mean it was a very close competition. I feel like the votes on this one were a little bit higher compared to the Estee Lauder ANR, but then there were so many people who were interested in both the products that I ended up actually buying both. So I'm currently testing out the Estee Lauder ANR, but for the past 1 month I have been using the Kiehl's Midnight Recovery Concentrate, and here I have to share my thoughts on the product. So first of all, this is a 30 ml bottle and it's priced at it's 3650. I can see it right here on the packaging itself. Definitely Estee Lauder ANR is a lot more expensive. It's 5700 for 30 ml. That's a lot of money, and this one is not cheaper either. But like you can see, I have just used up like around this much of it, and I use this every single night only. And you also don't need a lot of product, because so how the packaging works is you press the pump like this, you open the bottle, you have your clear fluid. It's a little bit yellow in color, and there's definitely a yellow tint to it, but it's not like yellow. You pump it, and can you see right here? It's got a very light consistency. It's very watery, but then once you massage it in, you can definitely see a glow on the skin. Can you see that shine? That is exactly what your whole face will look like after you put this on. And it also has a very nice floral herbaly kind of a scent. This is described as a replenishing elixir. It's got pure essential oils and distilled botanicals to visibly restore the appearance of skin by morning. So yeah, the ingredients are definitely very very like floral and herbaly, and I think that is what gives it this scent. I think this will be good no matter what your skin type is. If you have dry skin, if you have normal or combination skin, even if you have oily skin, I feel like since it's a nighttime product, it's going to work for your skin. It's also very 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 light on the skin, which is something I do really like about it. Now coming to the main idea behind this whole series is to tell you whether the product is worth the hype or not, which is why we talk about really popular hyped up products which are also very very expensive. And if I talk about this particular product in general, I don't think it's worth the hype. I feel like every single time I do a video, I talk about some of the other dupe. I had a dupe for Clinique Moisture Surge, which is not like a perfect dupe, but it's something which you can use if you wish to. I also had a dupe for Clinique Moisture Surge as well, and those ones again great. This one again, I feel like there is not just one dupe to talk about, there are multiple dupes, and I think it depends on what you're looking for. If you're looking for a consistency dupe, if you're looking for an ingredient dupe, like similar ingredients in the product, it depends on what exactly you're looking for. But to me, this is basically a very very lightweight facial oil as described on the packaging. It's like an elixir, it's a concentrate, it's not a serum, it's not a facial oil. Serums are more concentrated and are for more targeted like purposes. Like for example, you have a vitamin C serum, or you have a niacinamide serum, or you have an AHA serum or a BHA serum. This one I feel like is more like a facial oil, but like a very very lightweight facial oil that is just supposed to help in repairing your skin because of the good ingredients that it contains. And I feel like there are a lot of serums out there which do the exact same thing just like this one. The one that I can think on the back of my mind right now, it's the Dot & Key Night Essentials Serum, or like something like that. It's a very 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 tiny bottle, at priced around 500 or 600. So I think value for money wise, this is still going to be three times the price of that, which is a lot of money. It's a lot of money, and even that one I personally feel like is not that worth it, There is also the Miniso green tea oil, now that I think about, which also I feel like can be a great dupe for this in terms of the consistency, not really the ingredients, because that one I believe only has green tea oil and then like some other oils as well. So yeah, not a perfect ingredient dupe. Finding ingredient dupe will probably be a little bit more harder, but in terms of consistency, these are the two dupes I can think about. And I would rather spend my money on those if I had to get something like this. And personally, I feel like for my skincare routine, a product like this is not an absolute essential. Like for my daytime routine, I tend to go for moisturizers, and then I tend to go for like a vitamin C serum. And then for nighttime, I tend to go for, again, a nice heavy moisturizer along with an AHA or a BHA serum. And that is like the perfect overall skincare routine in me for general. So this particular thing, I don't really feel like is the ideal product for me. Like it's not necessary. I love to use it as like an additional step, but it's not like super duper essential, if you know what I mean. So yeah, that is kind of what my thoughts are on the product. But I do want to say one thing, that even though this is so pricey, I feel like this bottle is going to last you for at least a good 3 to 4 months. And that again depends on how often you're using it. If you're using it like maybe 2 times a day, it's going to last definitely for at least 2 to 2.5 months for sure. So yeah, those were my thoughts on this product. I know it was a pretty short one compared to what my videos are regularly, but yeah, I feel like I didn't really have a lot of things to say. I didn't want to make this video because a lot of you are really, really interested in this product because it is so hyped up, and I could definitely tell through your words. So yeah, that's the reason I wanted to make this video and let you guys know that even though it is a great product, it's got really good ingredients, and I love Kiehl's as a brand in general in terms of what they stand for and how natural the ingredients are, and they just put so much of good ingredients in their products, which I feel like is again a really, really good thing. But yeah, they're expensive and not something that everyone can afford, and even if you can spend that much money, you could rather save money and like put your money somewhere else. That is just what I personally feel, which is why I want to talk to you guys about this. And that is pretty much it for this video. I really hope that you guys enjoyed watching and it was helpful for you guys, and I could help you save some money and tell you guys that you don't need to necessarily go out there and spend $3,700 on a bottle of concentrate or serum or facial oil, whatever you want to call it. So yeah, that is pretty much it for this video. Definitely do make sure that you subscribe before you leave, because it would mean the world to me and it would help me so much. I can't even describe in words. So yeah, definitely do go ahead and subscribe. Also, hit the bell button, which is next to the subscribe button, because that way you'll get to know every single time I post a new video. And I will also leave my Instagram in the description box. That way you can participate in my poll the next time I decide to do one of these and I ask you guys which products you want to see. So definitely for that you need to follow me on my Instagram. And yeah, that's pretty much it for this video. Thank you so much for watching, you guys. Until next time. Bye. Bye.